This is Christopher with AG Productions, and welcome to this week's edition of Friday Afternoon Figures, where we take a look at some of the lesser-known miniature manufacturers out there that you might want to go check out. Now, who are we talking about today? Today we're going to talk about Smart Max Miniatures. Now, if you've never heard of Smart Max, that's okay. The link to their website is going to be down there in the video description. Go check them out at smartmaxstore.com. But Smart Max is a... They produce some very unique miniatures, and what you're going to hear today are words like unique and interesting and basically neutral qualifiers is what we're going to be using today. Because Smart Max, their miniatures look pretty cool, but at the same time, I think a lot of the coolness from their models comes from the paint jobs, and I don't know how cool those miniatures would be if they were painted by a novice painter instead of a professional painter. And so, I don't want to give them too much credit, but at the same time, they are fairly neat, and it's definitely something I think you should check out, okay? So, what does Smart Max produce? Well, Smart Max produces a line, actually two different lines of models, neither of which are going to fit into any game system that you play, more than likely, unless you still happen to play the Inquisitor game that Games Workshop put out years ago, because Smart Max miniatures are done in 54mm scale, which means they are almost twice the size of a model from either Warhammer 40K, Privateer Press, any of those type lines, okay? So, Smart Max has two lines, as I said. One of them is called Mouser Earth, which is essentially sort of a futuristic World War I / steampunk line. It's very reminiscent, to me, of the Mutant Chronicles series, if you've ever heard of that world. Some of you may have, some of you that probably means nothing to you. And that's fine. The other line that they have is what they call their Smog line, which is a Victorian steampunkish line of miniatures mixed with a little bit of Cthulhu. Now, this is where their miniatures are actually kind of neat looking. They've got a lot of really interesting models. They're very unique miniatures. But again, I think a lot of the appeal on the pictures that you're going to see at the end of this that have been pulled off the website is from the paint jobs on the miniatures. I would love to see one of these models painted up in a more cartoonish style. Again, even I would love to see one painted up by a novice painter, because the paint jobs that are on them are absolutely exquisite, and they were obviously done by someone who paints miniatures all day long. And so the models themselves are unique. I will definitely give them that. And some of them I've actually considered picking up. One of the major drawbacks, though, is the pricing structure. The prices are very expensive. You're talking at least 20 to 25 euros for a single miniature. So they're really, really pricey. But my hope would be that with that kind of pricing, that the quality of the models would be absolutely exquisite. So, there's not a whole lot I can say about Smart Max to describe to you what the miniatures are or what sort of ranges they have. You really just have to see them. And so keeping that in mind, I'm simply going to cut the video right here and just let you guys take a look at the still pics at the end of this video so you can see what some of their range looks like. If you enjoy their stuff, check out smartmaxstore.com. Again, the link is in the video description down there. And Smart Max Miniatures is the name of the company. Very, very interesting models, once again. You guys are going to see them here in just a few moments. So, that's it for today, guys. If you have any comments or questions, feel free to put them in the comment section down below. I would say join me tomorrow for This Week in Miniatures. But we're actually going to skip a week because I'm pretty sure you guys are tired of seeing Glade Guard Wood Elves. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to skip those for this week, come back next week, show you a fully completed set of those guys, as well as a couple of other miniatures that I'm going to paint up over the next week. So that's it for today, guys. God bless you all. Have a wonderful, awesome, outstanding rest of the day, and I will see you Sunday for this coming week's edition of Shout Out Sunday. Take care, everybody. Bye-bye.